your trip.
75% cousins.
75%. Yeah, so what are we going to title this? Despite popular belief and my shoes, I'm straight. Mostly.
Getting ready to go. We lost Fletcher. Don't know where he is. Oh, hold up a minute. There he is. We're here at the Cedar Tree Portage.
There we go. Yeah! No! Boys, cousins, canoe trip is officially a go.
It's right behind this little island.
So we're just pulling up to our site,
and there's a bunch of bass sitting right on the outside of it.
Huh. Eric will actually cast pretty well.
Huh.
There are schools upon schools of bass, but we're just gonna get ourselves set up in this dope little dark tree area.
Oh, lighting's probably trash.
Is my hairbrush.
But
found it.
Daniel?
Here is my hairbrush.
But day of highs and lows, a lot of nostalgia for me and Tim coming back to places we've been on Mark Mass trips.
More so Fletcher.
More so me. Look at how smooth this is. This is what we paddled through all day.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
Turtle friend.
Tim, do you want to say anything?
No, I would have said it.
Good night.
We got way too much, not enough sleep.
It's 6:30 and we've been up for an hour.
Is it 6:30? Dang, bro. We got gold.
We bid farewell to Cedar Tree Island.
Bye!
7 o'clock and it's already hot. There's a Tim. There's a Dan.
Hello.
And there is love between us.
We be portaging and stuff. We are in Flint.
Flint Lockwood!
Kind of calm and stuff.
Peaceful. Bliss.
He vibing.
Tim has either found a catfish or a cactus in the water here.
Look out.
Ouch.
Wow, great canoeing.
That's good.
Catfish.
Eyeballs.
That is definitely a catfish. What in the world? That is weird.
Maybe that's like bullhead or something.
That's kind of what it looks like to me.
Caught a few small pike. Flying the drone, getting some cool shots. Oh yeah.
Encountered a few problems. The spot that we were looking to stay out for lunch, we can't find. Tim is out doing that. We were gonna do it with the drone, but for some reason, the drone can't let me leave
50 meters distance because I got logged out for some reason.
And it's hot, and wow, why didn't you tell me my hair looked like that? And we're hungry.
And I caught
actually, that looks half decent. It kind of looks like spiders. I kind of like it, but I at the same time, I really don't.
Screw it, say we. We cannot find high rock, but we are starving, and we found this beautiful beach to swim on.
Well-deserved granola bar to me.
We're all pretty hangry. We are, we're just roasting these over the natural heat of the sand because of how hot it is out. It is delicious.
What, Doik?
Tim be swimming and he caught himself a friend.
One-eyed Jack. One-eyed
oh, wow.
Jack.
He's,
huh. Gonna, he's gonna get you.
Okay, we're gonna put one-eyed Jack back.
Bye, one-eyed Jack.
Bye, one-eyed Jack. Bye, one-eyed Jack.
Nap time. I think we fell asleep. It was a good time though. Last little bit on caviar. Almost getting ready for our portage into Isinglass now.
How's
ready?
Say your thing again.
No.
Oh. I was gonna say we had a straight up clutch nap.
So, here's what I vote we do.
Turtle friend.
Urinate.
Okay, oh, are you filming?
Sorry, Mom.
We found the portage into Isinglass.
Bro, why did it take me so long to put on my pants?
Bro, we need pants. Go naked.
What?
But now, I haven't hit a fork in the road. I've just hit a road. I'm guessing it's straight ahead, but I'll wait for the boys just to make sure. Why?
Safety first.
Here it is. The lake which dreams are made of.
Ah, it's just water.
Lake Louise.
We are in Isinglass, which I've just learned is the fourth clearest lake in North America. And I'm not sure how good the camera picks this up. But like that water looks like so blue.
Water is straight bussin'.
Like it looks like we were talking like the Kool-Aid jammers, the tropical punch. I think it is. I don't think the camera's picking that up, but that's bussin'. And this is like, you drink this water and you're like, respectfully.
Typically, if you drink water, you're
the water is so clear, oh yeah, it is gorgeous, like me, Tim is kinda cool.
We did it, we're here.
A dead bird!
What? At the Isinglass camping spot. Wow, that is a big dead bird.
That one looks fresh.
Supper tonight.
Bussin'!
Hello, future us. We have an update for you.
A margarine that exploded
in our food bin.
In our food bin.
Meat boy. Teresa Stamler would approve keeping Smokies out all day in the sun. And then doing it on an unclean surface.
Go back to Thailand.
Not like we... Tim?
Not where she
Indonesia.
I'm in the lake.
Yes.
Bustin'! Respectfully!
Future us, you might be wondering, where the heck is Katrina? Why is she not here? We've provided this brief reenactment to show you exactly what happened.
Hi, Grant. It's Katrina. So, I'm supposed to go on the canoe trip tomorrow, but I don't know how I'm supposed to do it. My heart's just not in it. My heart is with you. And if I don't go, things will never be the same. And if I leave, we won't be able to talk for 2 hours every evening, which averages out to 14 hours a week. While I was watering my organic zucchini in my garden, that I love, but not as much as you, I was brought to tears because I realized that it had been 10 hours, 46 minutes, and 11 seconds since we had last chatted. And I just couldn't bear the thought of it being 176 hours, 12 minutes, and 14 seconds, the time I'm away on the canoe trip. And what of my worms? What shall they do in my absence? Have I informed you of my tadpoles? I know we talked about them for 36 minutes last night, but figured I would bring it up again with you this morning. They continue to eat each other's limbs freshly as they are grown. Oh, perhaps this is because I have not fed them in 3 weeks. You know, I'm much like a tadpole myself. I want nothing more than to please everybody, to be on land and to be in the water, and yet the people around me tear my limbs off, and they pull my heart in separate directions. It would please my cousins greatly to be on this trip, but my love is for you and not for them. Oh, Grant, you are such a good listener. Have I ever told you that? You always know what to say.
We've been passed out napping for the past hour and a half. It's 9:30 now, so we're waking up so we can pack up our things and go to bed.
Don't tell us that now. Fletcher's just told us he has a problem and that he's feeling gaseous.
I feel fine, but I'm warning you, I'm not gonna smell good here by the end of the night.
Right. So my biggest problem is that I have not applied deodorant yet this trip.
Good night.
Come and sleep. Good morning, campers.
That was a very good sleep.
Morning is ready.
Might be too good. Tim's already making pancakes. What does this?
Oh, I just popped my hip out.
Happy Canada Day!
Happy Canada Day! Canada, you are 154 today. Happy birthday!
Wow, sounds like my parents.
Pancakes!
Purchased Tim a headbanger lure, and we haven't seen it in action yet. We're excited for it to catch him a monster.
Swimming. Heading out, gonna do some fishing here on Isinglass. Let's go.
Tim's first fish on the headbanger, apparently. It's a lake trout.
Oh, he's cute.
Can I pet him?
They're smooth.
Whoa, are they ever.
Whoa.
so lovely.
Just getting some more gorgeous shots of this lake. It is certified
beautiful.
Fishing. Just kidding. I fooled you. Ha! We're not fishing. We're on the beach. It was a good day. Tim has said what a freaking day probably 11 times?
Yes. But it was in the span of about 4 minutes.
What a freaking day.
Oh, I look like a tool, don't I?
Guess what we're doing.
Fishing.
Daniel guessed right. Beauty day for a bunch of beauty gays.
What
the? We are having a bit of a situation.
The reel broke, so I'm twisting the fish in, but it's here now. That is unfortunate. So, what are you doing?
Vlogging.
Just portaged into what appears to be another fairly gorgeous looking lake. I believe this one is Shingwalk. Look at how tiny this little guy is. Fletcher.
Yeah, I don't want to hurt his shell.
So you threw him in the lake?
What? Hello, future us. Tim here. To show you snails. Wow. So we are on a beach and we're having fun. Huge mussels.
Okay, Fletcher, what was the bait you wanted? We're ready.
I want the bait that's gonna get the most fish. Yep. Tim, what are we getting ready to do? And?
Don't need to get ready to do something you're already doing.
Dang, you're
stay
right.
Stay cute.
Dang. What's an activity?
What is that? There's something swimming. Is this, it's a turtle. Oh, it is a snake.
Is a snake a snake?
Go catch it.
Good fish, Fletcher.
How to know when you've been out in the sun too long? Fletcher and I were just paddling along.
And he goes, whoa, what was that? Did you see that? I was like, what? It looked like a piece of wood, but like straight cut, like a 2x4. And I'm like your paddle?
It's a hot day, I'm dehydrated, and I want to go home.
He saw his paddle and went, what is that?
Cactus. Tim found cactuses.
Would not want to step on them, it would hurt your feet.
These are the queer socks.
We call them that because they attract men.
Apparently.
Hello, future us. Tim here. Fletcher lost his sunglasses. But while we were looking, we found an egg. It's huge. It's polka dotty. So we're not sure. Like, it's big, so maybe elephant.
Portage from Xinhuac into the next one. Otter skin? Cameron. Into Cameron. Here we go. Goose. Hello, goose. Goodbye, goose. Have fun, goose. Cameron Lake camping spot. Oh, there's more tables over here. What the sus? Dang. It's nice.
Yeah, well, Nate didn't find the spot.
It's bussing. We've been missing Katrina so much, we see her when she's not even there.
Katrina, what are you doing? What do you want from us?
In the middle of the forest, leave us alone.
What the heck are you doing here? This is weird.
Check out our two-tier hammock. And my own.
There's a ledge. A divider between
separate.
His leg.
A divider here. This is innovation. Elon Musk, we're coming for you.
Okay,
yeah.
No more.
Stop it. Stop.
Hello, future us. Hello, future us. It's Tim here with another exciting vlog update to show you the noodles that I cooked. One minor problem, I thought this was one cup, but it's actually two cups. So I may or may not have put a lot too much water in them. But they will be delicious nonetheless because I poured our margarine, kind of soupy. And so yeah, it's pretty exciting. Fletcher has been trying to set up his hammock for the past probably 3 to 9 hours.
I think it's upside down.
Bussin'.
When the noodle soup is bussin', respectfully.
Fletcher and I have been relaxing in the hammocks.
Tim's been preparing some kind of something over here. I saw him grab peanut butter. I saw him grab a bunch of other things. And he chucked it all on this propane torch thing. Tim, what the sus are you doing?
I made a creation.
Okay.
What I call it?
I want to hear about it.
Okay. I call it apples, peanut butter, Nutella, and bread in a can. And marshmallows in a can. Heat it up.
Hey, I'm going to do my best Daniel voice.
Viewers, try to guess before we comment below what you think this is.
Okay, it's not bear scat. Big comment.
Does it really look that bad?
Yes. No, it looks delicious.
I call it
Jim surprise.
Nutella, peanut butter, apples, bread, marshmallows, and a little bit of margarine in a can.
Oh, why'd you put margarine in there?
Heat it up. A margarine a day keeps your children gay.
And don't you forget it.
Welcome back to our cooking show called Is It Bussin'?
Is it though?
We'll be back after these messages. Shop Cloverleaf Grocery for your most expensive groceries and the least expensive price. What?
What?
Welcome back to Is It Bussin', where we find out is it bussin'?
Today, let's have a look at the dish.
Show them the dish. Go bring it over there. Show it to them.
This is the dish. It looks
bear poop surprise.
Like it might have come out of the back end of something.
Okay, I like to call it.
Tim, you go first. Okay, or we all try it at once.
No. I'm telling them what I call it. Okay. I call it marshmallows, bread, apple, peanut butter, Nutella, and margarine. In a can. Heat it up. It's pretty
I think I'm the best. I'm the next Master Chef Tim.
All at once?
3, 2, 1.
That's pretty good. I hit a marshmallow and it was really weird.
That is the best apple marshmallow.
I would sub out the bread for more marshmallows.
Marshmallow, apple, and margarine can heated up I've ever tasted.
The bread is not buzzing. It tastes a lot better than it looks.
That is delicious.
But I wouldn't call it delicious. Okay. It's pretty good.
That's probably the best thing I've ever eaten.
I could definitely do without the apple, too.
I think I'm going to become rich.
That's not bad, though.
This has been Is It Bussin'? Tune in next time.
Wait, is it bussin'?
Oh, bussin'. Dang.
It never is bussin'.
You know what? It's bussin'.
Yeah, it's bussin'. Tune in next time.
Not a high key bussin', but it's bussin'.
Calories.
Tune in next time for...
What's next?
This might be a one-time show.
Look at how beautiful Comet is. This is how it's been, like, every day.
Stonks.
This is amazing.
It stonks, not gonna lie. I think that's what it means.
Bussin' stonks.
We're gonna go to this big tree right here, yeah? And jump off of it?
The one that has...
No, not that one.
Not that one?
You're zooming in on the wrong one.
That one. We're gonna go jump off this tree here.
See that curvy branch?
That's where you stand on?
Yeah, that's where you jump from.
Okay,
yeah.
Nice. This looks a little bit sketch, in my opinion.
It's highly sketch.
You go first. I'm scared.
There's a curved stick.
Oh, okay. Okay, you can stop it and stuff.
Dang, he hit the water hard, though. So?
Bussin'.
Okay.
You actually have upper body strength.
Daniel, who do you think has more upper body strength? Avery Lundgren or you? Yeah, but...
Avery Lundgren.
Daniel.
Hands down. Avery Lundgren.
Alright.
Live your life.
Okay.
Shoot your shot.
Going?
Florence loves you.
Yeet. Woo! How was it? That was pretty lit. Yeah, good. I like it. I love it. I want some more of it. Sam, are you almost there?
Okay, I got a couple of nincompoops in a tree. Ready? Okay, I don't know if I see you hit the water, but I'll try my fastest. Steady, Freddy!
3, 2, 1.
Mine wasn't good enough.
Bussin! That was kind of scary. I like the other one better.
Okay, nincompoop number two coming through.
3, 2, 1, bussin!
Okay, I gotta do it at least once, I guess.
That's right.
I do not like doing this. I do this because it's the right thing to do. I do this because it will prove me okay with scary things. I hate this. I hate this.
Should I move?
Oh, I hate this. I hate doing this.
So do I.
I hate this so much. I don't hate it
though. Bye, Tim.
I don't think Tim likes it very much.
Bye. I'm telling you one thing for certain.
Can't even see him.
I hate this.
I wonder if he enjoys doing that.
Oh, I hated that.
That sucked. Okay. Can I go now?
Yeah, go.
Okay. I don't have to poop anymore, though.
No, go.
Yeet.
Good.
I was almost contemplating doing a backflip, and then I'm like, nah, I can't.
Tomorrow, we're gonna fish otter skin.
It was a beautiful day today.
This is the Void speaking.
Oh, nice. That was my nickname in grade school.
What?
Because I just ate all the teachers. No, it was a good day of,
what did we do?
Paddled.
You did a little bit of bass fishing. Oh.
Night.
Tim wants to go to bed.
We're awake.
Super grains for the super gains.
Well, looking out at the lake, it appears to be another windy day. And it's kind of crazy to navigate. I feel really sorry for Tim, who has to use the one-man canoe.
Oh, I'm gonna work out a canoe and this stuff.
This is crazy, bro.
Oh, why the wind going so fast, bro?
Hungry fish is a monger fish. You heard it here first, folks.
That's when I was sitting over there in that big one.
Heading out for the day. Goodbye.
Bro, this wind so fast, bro. Water.
What? Okay, we're just like canoeing and stuff, and Tim took a Jesus pill. What the sus? What are you doing, buddy? We're literally perfectly in the middle of the lake, and this guy just turns into Jesus. What do you, how? What?
Man, you got a lot of faith.
That is amazing. Tim, your canoe's floating away.
Come for me.
We're coming. Oh my goodness.
And you can't even see.
That's wow, insane. Crazy. We took his canoe. But that looks so crazy.
We're taking his canoe. What?
Fishing near the Jesus Rock. Right. Tim's got a good fish on him.
Nice bass. Thank you, Fletcher. That is a hog. That's definitely my biggest bass ever. That is huge.
Daniel with a hog of a smallmouth.
He's 20. He's 20. A 20-inch bass. Getting ready to go into otter skin.
She's a warm one, dear.
Otter skin looks dope. Portage, not so much.
This campsite is insane, but the lake, oh my goodness.
Tim describes it as isinglass with bass. Insane. Oh, there's a bass right there. Just following us. This is insane. I love this lake. Eat bass and bass. I like that noise. But not as much as I like this campsite.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
That is gorgeous. 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 Gorgeous.
Oh. Seem interested.
That's what I mean. It's frustrating sometimes. Well, he likes Fletcher's
sometimes
manager.
They like the drop, though. Oh, they see it and they leap. They're like, and I got the small one.
Woo!
he's excited. I didn't get a big one, but I got one. So that's good. Hello, friend.
Hi, buddy.
Really? It's like isinglass with bass. It is simply the best.
Thanks, son.
Swimming and things.
Hits different.
Look how creamy that is. Welcome back to Is It Bussin'?
It's not even a question. Is bussin'. Out in the canoe, all three of us doing some bass fishing.
Fletcher's got a big one. Fletcher's got a nice one.
Come on, man.
We have a lot of fish, and they're all pretty nice size. They're fighting nice.
Okay, how do we
and eating rice?
It's like a silver colored.
Come here, buddy.
It's like
they're cool colored fish.
That's cool. Wait. Very light.
I don't know why you got the sun in the background.
That's crazy.
is delicious bread.
Delicious bread.
If anyone ever questions our intelligence again, look at how we tied up the boat. With our scissors, because we don't have rope, but we improvise, we adapt,
empathize,
and we overcome. Oh. Don't ever use the word smart with me. Goodbye, mousetrap. We'll see you later.
Bye. Back to fishing. It doesn't take long.
Come get y'all unhooked. We have proven evidence that rock bass are a larger species than smallmouth bass.
That's probably my biggest smallmouth.
That's probably my smallest rock bass.
That's an enormous rock bass.
Say goodbye. He's so cute.
Oh,
wow. What? He under the canoe. He dead.
So it's been a bit of a somber mood around camp lately. I've had my orange Volcom shirt now. This will be its 10th summer. I bought it before I moved out to Emo for the first time for the summer. And it has come with me on every single canoe trip. It has been my work shirt. It was my school shirt. It's getting to the end of its life. And it's starting to get holes. And every time I take it off, I'm scared it's going to rip. But I didn't want to have it have just a regular end because it's been such a special shirt for me because it's been on every adventure ever. And so I thought rather than have it rip in the washing machine and get used for rags, we're going to give it a final resting place on my favorite lake ever. But we're going to give him a burial place. Yeah, he let some air through. He's getting a little risque. But we're going to give him a final resting place there and maybe do a little service for him.
Tears
and
will be shed.
A lot of tears. And maybe make a little engraving or a plaque or a memorial or something. So, the end.
We're up here at the final resting spot. It is a pretty nice view up here.
When he's like a river, attendeth my way. When sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul, it is well, it is well with my soul, with my soul, it is well.
We have finished our first part of the parting ceremony. Tim is, as we speak, carving something into the tree. The engraving has been finished. Orange Volcom shirt from 2012 until 2021. Where we leave him now.
That's his final resting place, eh?
We are saying farewell
to
the spot. Goodbye, Orange Volcom shirt.
One last goodbye.
Did it work?
Supper!
You're really zoomed in there, buddy.
Like this?
There we go.
Hello, future us. Tim here again with another exciting update. We are having wild rice soup that I cooked with my own bag of pre-made soup mix. Good job, me.
No content for you. No, my spoon is still in there.
Fletcher had the soup in his shirt. Went, oh no, this is a problem. His shirt was being dipped into the soup.
I have a remedy.
Let's see what he can do. Good job.
Ah, it's hot.
Hello, future us. Tim here with another exciting update. That is where Fletcher slipped.
A little higher. He was in the hammock. Went right back over.
He was in the hammock and went right back over. I wasn't watching. And then hit something. But anyway, the good thing is, I don't know, oh, you can't really see it. He's got a dinosaur on his back now. So see, there's the tail. There's the legs.
Damn, ow, that hurts.
And then there's the head.
Hey. How is your poop? Stop. Go away.
How'd it go?
It went.
Hello. Oh. Nice. Good hair.
Ow, run for miles just to get a taste. Must be love on the brain. I love that. Ow, run for miles. Ow. I need to get that. I should. Tim, you should. Yeah. Tim, are you Rihanna?
Yes.
Yeah, I am.
Good night.
Good morning. We have some bad news. In the night, Fletcher's dinosaur has passed away. It is no longer with us. It is extinct. It has gone the way of the rest of the dinosaurs.
Tim is winking at us all morning and making us some delicious
pancake.
How does it feel to be the greatest pancake maker in the world?
It's just kind of normal, because that's what I am.
Want to tell me about your birthday? Daniel turns 4 today.
It's my birthday! For my birthday gift on my birthday. With a birthday gift for my birthday on my birthday? With a birthday gift? Happy birthday.
He turns 4 at the store today.
I started working at Cloverleaf on July 3rd, 2017, 4 years ago today. Happy birthday, me. Thank you.
There's a thing. Oh, what?
What the sus is in there?
What did you find? What is?
A drank.
A drank.
I think it's a SCOBY.
Yeah, it kind of looks like it.
Mom would drink it.
Probably. Oh, that is. Oh, that do be SCOBY like.
That actually does look quite a bit like a SCOBY. Oh, nasty. Delicious. Yeah, she'll take it.
Out in the boat, doing some fishy fish. Here's one. He's kind of cute and stuff. Fletcher's fish is taking off like a lake trout. That thing is fighting. Let's see how big it is.
That's a big fish.
That's nice.
Leaving.
Otter skin.
About to start singing Sesame Street, so it's a good thing you said that.
Otter skin.
Back in Cameron, headed on our way
The wind is headwind, but we're doing okay because we're strong and big muscled and stuff.
We got a pipe with some nasty on the side. What even is that, bro?
Woo!
It looks like nasty corn. Beep a damn. Keep going. Here we go.
Things have gone from bad to worse. There's a giant damn thing that drops like 2 feet, and then we can't get through that. And then we hit a road, and then we had a ton of fallen trees, and then the creek gets narrower and narrower. We've double-checked it a few times. We are on the right spot.
So we're buckling down for a very rough go here. Here we go.
So we learned some valuable lessons. Well, I think we should have learned that on the last trip, is plan for the unexpected, or expect the unexpected, or check ups, or... Wow.
There's still water.
And you gotta believe in yourself, and you gotta just really push and to achieve it.
We have one more canoe to get.
We've got one already. Yeah, we found Fletcher a snack. Here, Fletcher, take the camera.
While he was taking the fishing rods, we found him a snack, and we stored it in the canoe. To eat for supper.
Oh, there it goes.
What the sus?
We named him Sheldon.
I love him.
Because he's beautiful. And he's got no hair. Yeah, that's the other
Excuse
one.
Me?
And he, look at him.
Soon, once he grows to be a little bit bigger, he will be what they refer to in the nature world as mature.
Now this here was by far the worst part, because it's like a big drop here and you can't really throw the canoes over, but we somehow did because we're amazing. And then we walked our gear along the side here. Some of the worst parts is that, you know, you have all this water here, but you can't, it's not deep enough for a canoe to go along. So we're walking in water carrying our canoes rather than canoeing. So. Not good, but we are, this is all we have left to take over, and then we're good. So we're actually decently surprised with how well that went. Good job, us. This is Sheldon. We're gonna say goodbye to him. Blessings on y'all. Have a good week.
See you next week.
See you next time, or
Tuesday Bible.
It might be 10 o'clock, might be 9 and 10:30, might be Wednesday.
We'll send you a text.
We'll let you know, and bring a lawn chair, bring a friend. Blessings on y'all. Have a good week.
That's right.
Look both ways.
Boga singing that. Oh, we're doing that.
This was the most anti-bussing spot.
We nicknamed it anti-bussing because it was anti-bussing.
This also is anti-bussing. I helped the first time, I promise. Also, Fletcher picked up a lily in the creek and it's been on here the whole time.
How we don't know. We think it loves us. More than anyone else.
Aww.
Aww.
This is also the same anti-bussing spot and stuff. Here we go.
Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above the heavenly. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Good.
We think Tim has caught us some supper.
Oh, shoot, it's a
Walleye! Oh. Let's follow! Oh, dang, that is a nice fish. That is a nice walleye. We have come across
some hieroglyphs.
We are all very tired right now.
I don't think we even mentioned we are in Stephen Lake. Everyone calls it Stevens, though, so
this
Stevens.
We've got a camping spot on a random island here. Tim is cooking the walleye he got and some fries. Fletcher is, oh, also potatoing. Oh, good job, potato.
Fletcher, if you could describe this food in one word, what would it be?
Awesome. I'm having salt and everything and stuff. It's so good.
It do be tasty. Oh, nice hair. Aha.
Protein deficient. We eating peanut butter right out the jar. Thanks, Morgan, for the discount. $3.
This one for you, Morgan. This one? This for you.
The sunset is bussing.
Yeah, I've been trying to hang
out. It's not really showing up on the camera, but it looks pretty nice in person. The fish has helped us recover. We are a lot more awake. Good night.
Oh, I missed him.
Good morning. It is our last day.
Of it.
Hello, Jay. Saying hi to our friend.
So it rained in the night, so around 4 a.m. we just had to put the cover over. But it's okay, and it stopped raining now. Beautiful blue skies.
And looks like Jay's coming back one more time. Looping around one more time.
Oh, he actually might land. That'd be kind of cool.
Oh, yo, I think he will. What the sus?
That'd be really cool. That's
oh,
cool.
He definitely landed.
What in the actual world? Katrina is been flown in. What the sus? We're giving them half of our things because we don't need a tent tonight. We don't need sleeping bags. So, because it's our last day, so we're just giving it to them. Let's foe. It's a good trade. A Katrina for a bunch of Twinkie bags. I like that trade. Goodbye! Katrina, did you bring us cinnamon buns too?
Let's foe!
Cinnamon buns?
Dad stole one.
That's okay.
Oh! Wait, wait, Tim! If you could describe this in one word.
Pretty good.
Bussin'!
Yeah!
Well, after a delicious cinnamon bun and an amazing surprise, we're ready to head off with one extra passenger.
There's a beaver dam and a cool looking bridge.
Fletcher wants me to vlog the flowers.
Wow, they are beautiful.
Yeah, oh.
We are in Flint.
Flint Lockwood.
Flint Lockwood.
And if you look to your left, you'll see the single people in here. Note their strange and silly headwear. Scientists now believe that perhaps their fashion sense has a correlation to their relationship status.
Tim caught a fish for lunch.
We are at the end of our portage into Cedar Tree.
I would say this was a pretty good cousin's canoe trip.
plus Isaac, minus Katrina, without Isaac, with a guest appearance from Katrina.
Indeed.
Oh, hello.
Oh, that's beautiful. Can you guys see the colors on it from there?
He's pretty, yeah.
Oreo.
Fletcher, does this place look oddly familiar?
This place be looking oddly familiar. And there's a
what? What the heck? Katrina's here.
Still. Thanks.
One of the key ingredients to having a successful canoe trip is organization. And we couldn't have done it without this man right here. Real quick, let's just give a thank you to him. Good job, Tim. But one of the key things to canoe trips is organization, like I say. So we categorize our food into very specific containers. So we have kitchen stuff, rando food, and bread and things.
Hello, future us. Tim here with another exciting update. We are having
fishes. Craft dinners
with Daniel, Fletcher, and Katrina, and me.
One thing we're looking forward to when we return is we stashed a recovery pack in the truck waiting for us so that when we get back we have a civilization kit of random goodies to help us re-enter society and feel what it is like to be young again.
Daniel got a good bass.
Yes, thank you.
Ah!
Heading on our way out. And here it is. The end of our journey.
Tough to let it go. That was an amazing trip.
Getting the boat ready. At Crow. We're done paddling. Phenomenal trip. Phenomenal.
So basically, we had to haul two canoes over, but now we have an extra person, but we have a few less dry bags. So replacing the dry bags today is your favorite and mine. Where is he?
Hello.
Where are you? Oh, there you are.
Hello, campers. We are departing from our last portage. The Lord has willed that we would go today.
Amen.
And today we are going.
Yeah, we out here in the canoes and stuff.
Oh yeah, boy.
We in the canoes. It's a little bit tight, but we out here.
Just the way I like it.
Fletcher is more safe now.
Let's go, not gonna die if we tip.
That's right.
Woo!
Hallelujah.
Back where it all started, at Muskie Bay, whatever the heck place.
Resort.
Yep. We are here in the truck, air conditioning, happy. And we're ready to go through our recovery pack. We
Dang,
can't.
Son.
You pick the item and go through it.
Let's start small.
Okay. Can you pack this?
Okay. Tic Tacs. Wow. Let's go.
Yeah.
A fake apple.
Oh, it's fake?
Oh, dang, son.
Oh, what?
I knew I'd get you.
Pretzels.
Pretzels.
Goldfish.
Goldfish.
Hella Bucky Floppo.
Bucky Floppo.
Oh, yeah.
Vitamins?
Car gummy vitamins?
Oh, let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah, do this one. No, do that one.
This one?
Yeah.
Gum.
Oh. Corona gun.
Temperature checker. Let's see how hot Tim is.
Super hot.
Sun-kissed skin. So hot, it will melt your popsicle.
He's only 89, too. Anyway, mints, because we all need that for our breath.
And that's it.
Okay, good.
Awesome.
So all in all, I'd say that's a pretty good recovery pack.
And it was an amazing trip with amazing people. I'm very glad we did it.
Color me red.